NBC kids, how are you all? I'm so glad that you are with us and we can have Sunday school together. But for this morning, I really need your help. I've lost something very, very special that someone, my dear friend, gave me. It's my special Bible. It's a beautiful Bible that she gave me. So I need you all's help to find that Bible. Are you ready? Are you ready for this little hunt? All right, come, let's search for my special Bible. Okay, where can it be? Well, I remember I left it in one of the classrooms. Could it be here? Huh. Do you guys see anything? The Bible is green. It has flowers on it. Let's look. Let's look over there. There's stacks of Bible right here. Do you see anything? Do you see a Bible? Oh, look! I found it! Look what I found! I found my Bible! Yay! Yay, 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 yay! Oh, praise the Lord! I found my beautiful Bible. Now it's found. Well, have you ever experienced anything like this where you lost something very special and you cannot find it? Have you ever felt that feeling? You're sad and something just gone from you because it's very special for you. So this is kind of the lesson that we're going to learn this morning. So I want you to pay attention to the video that's going to be put up. All right.
Jesus used parables to teach people. A parable is a story Jesus told to help people understand the kingdom of God. The parable of the lost sheep. Jesus taught, "Is there one here among you who would not leave his herd of 99 sheep to search for a lost sheep until he finds it?" Or like when I lost one of my toys and I had to look in the caverns under my bed. Oh man, dark times. Anyway, when he finds the lost sheep, the shepherd puts him on his shoulders. He calls out to his neighbors and friends, "Rejoice! I have found my lost sheep!" Jesus said that in heaven, there will be more joy over one lost person who repents of his sin than over 99 people who did not need to repent. The parable of the lost coin. A woman had 10 silver coins. One of them was lost. The woman looked everywhere. She swept the house and kept on searching for the coin. When she found it, she called her friends to celebrate. Jesus said that in that same way, the angels rejoice when one person turns to God. The parable of the lost son. A man had 2 sons. One day, the younger son said to his father, "Give me my share of the inheritance." So the father gave the younger son his part. The younger son packed his bags and went to the distant land where he lived foolishly and wasted his inheritance. He sounds like my little brother. Being tired and hungry, he decided to go home. He said to himself, "Even the servants in my father's house eat better than this. I will go back to my father and ask if I can work for him, because I am no longer worthy to be called his son." So the son headed for home. While he was still a long way off, his father saw the son coming toward the home. The father ran to him, threw his arms around him, and kissed him. The son said, "I have sinned against God and against you." But the father told his servants, "Bring the best robe for my son. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Let's have a feast and celebrate. This son of mine was lost, and now he is found."
Okay, so you guys watched the video. What did you think? Did you learn something from the video? Well, I asked you the question a while ago. Have you ever lost something very special for you? Did you find it? How did you get it back? Did you have to look for it? Did you have to search for it and then ask people's help? Well, here we're going to learn, all right, from the book of Luke, Luke chapter 15. Well, in chapter 15, Jesus teaches us about parables. Parables. What is a parable? What does parable mean? Well, a parable is a story Jesus told to help people understand the kingdom of God. Yes, a parable is a story Jesus told to help people to understand the kingdom of God. All right, there are three parables from Luke 15. The first one, all right, is the parable of the lost sheep. The parable of the lost sheep. Listen to the story. Jesus taught, "Is there one here among you who would not leave his herd of 99 sheep to search for a lost sheep until he finds it? When he finds the lost sheep, the shepherd puts him on his shoulders. He calls out to his neighbors and friends, 'Rejoice with me! I have found my lost sheep!'" Jesus said that in heaven there will be more joy over one lost person who repents of his sin than over 99 people who do not need to repent. That's our first parable. What's the second parable? The second parable is the parable of the lost coin. The parable of the lost coin. So here it is. A woman had 10 silver coins. One of them was lost. The woman looked everywhere. She swept the house and kept on searching for the coin. When she found it, she called her friends to celebrate with her. Jesus said that in the same way, the angels rejoice when one person turns to God. That was our second. And this is our third parable. What's the third parable? The third parable of the lost son. A man had two sons. One day, the younger son said to his father, "Give me my share of the inheritance." So the father gave the younger son his part. The younger son packed his bags and went to a distant land where he lived foolishly and wasted his inheritance. Being tired and hungry, he decided to go home. He said to himself, "Even the servants in my father's house eat better than this. I will go to my father and ask if I can work for him, because I am no longer worthy to be called his son." So the son headed home. While he was still a long way off, his father saw the son coming toward home. The father ran to him, threw his arms around him, and kissed him. The son said, "I have sinned against God and against you." But the father told his servants, "Bring the best robe for my son. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Let's have a feast and celebrate. The son of mine was lost, and now he is found." Okay, so did you enjoy those three parables? This is a very, very, very good story. So, we learned about those three parables. So, the first parable, okay, the first parable was about the sheep. That's the first parable. What about the second parable? The second parable was about the coin. All right, the second parable is about the coin. What about the third parable? What is it about? What was it about? Do you remember? It was about the sun. Good. Yes, it's about the sun. Okay, so what happened to the sheep, the coin, and to the sun? Who remembers? There's one word that every parable has. It's the same word. What is it? I can't hear you. What is it? That's right. All of them were lost. Yes, all of them were lost. So, the similarities were the sheep, the coin, and the son were lost. But what happened next? What happened next? If something is lost, what do we need to find? You remember what happened to me when I lost my Bible? What did I have to do? What did I have to do in order to get it back? I had to look for it. I had to find. I had to search where it was. So, after you find or search, you have that something very valuable in your hands. What's the next action? What would you do? Would you just lay around? Yeah. Or would you, let's celebrate. Yay! You're happy. You're so, oh, you feel so good. Something, you have it in your hands. Oh, so what would you do? You would celebrate. Okay, so from our three parables, okay, we can see something that is lost. We will find, we can find it. If we have it, then we celebrate. Even if that's that one thing, even that one thing. Okay, this shows our story about Jesus. Jesus cares about that one thing, one person. Okay, remember the sheep? How many? There was 100, but that there was 100, but that one sheep was lost. Yes, one sheep was lost. But when that sheep came back, it was a celebration because it was so valuable. It was something that is precious, something that is precious that needs a celebration. So when someone comes to Jesus and believes in Jesus and repents, that is a celebration. The angels in heaven are singing. So what's our job? What should we do? You remember, Pastor Rob, about our theme of, about our lesson, our theme this month? It's what? Who's your one? Who's your one? So remember, that's one person, that special person that you have in mind, whether it's your family, whether it's your friends, or anyone you know, your neighbor. Okay, who's that one that you have been praying for? Continue and faithfully pray for them because they are precious. They are precious in Jesus' eyes. Okay, so let's find our one. Let's pray for our one and just continue to pray and be faithful. And I hope you learn from our parables this morning. And I am so thankful. I'm so thankful, even though we are not sitting in a classroom together, but I'm so thankful for technology. We can still learn God's word together and we can glorify him through this morning. Well, I hope you all have a wonderful, wonderful week. All right. And I want to teach you a song before we end this lesson. And we're going to pray together.
Good, so good for me.
what did you think about the song? Wasn't it good? The title of the song is I Will Follow You, and I hope it was meaningful for you all. Well, it's a time for us to end our lesson this morning, and I'm so thankful that we can worship together and we can learn about the Bible together. And before we go, let's pray. Father, thank you for today. Thank you for this morning. Even though we're far apart and we're in different places, but we're thankful that we can still worship you. We can still learn about your word. And thank you for our lessons this morning about the parables. Thank you for teaching us. And Father, let us help us just to continue to be faithful. Help us to trust in you and continue to follow you wherever you go. Father, and help us as well so we can share the love of Christ to our friends, to our family, to our neighbors, to those, the ones that have not known you yet, the ones that are lost, and we can share the love of Jesus to them. And Father, we just especially want to thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, that has died on the cross for us, for your grace and for your mercy and for all your blessings. And we just pray, and in Jesus' name, amen. Well, you all have a great week. Bye.